Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. As we begin the new year, there's so much focus on wellness for our bodies, but our next guest knows we can never neglect our mental health. Here to help us work on healthy relationships is psychiatrist Dr. Dwight A. Owens. Welcome to the show, Woo! Sir.
Thanks for having me.
So happy to have you.
Well, you know, I'm gonna begin, because, you know, I'm newly married. and you always talk about understanding boundaries. How do we set those boundaries, and how do we know where to begin?
I think that we first have to have that conversation. Each of us as individuals, we have our own specific desires, our needs and our wants. And sometimes when we tend to get into relationships or new marriages, we tend to fuse everything together. And that can be very dangerous, because you may need 10 minutes just to woosah.
Right.
Or you may need to take a trip with your girlfriends, your sisters, and just hang out. And sometimes when we get in these heavy, heavy relationships, we forget who we are as individuals and what our needs are.
Yeah.
And that can be very dangerous.
Yeah.
Now, when we get into some of these altercations or kerfuffles with our loved one or better half, you talk about how it's better to talk the problem out before it really starts to get bad, you know, for lack of a better word. What does that process look like?
I think first thing, you have to identify if there is a real problem. Because sometimes we have imagined issues. We think there's something that's going on.
Or even if we think we made it bigger than what it might have been.
Correct. So you have to first see if there is a real problem. Now, once you figure there's a real problem, allow your partner to talk. Oh, how do you feel? And then take a minute, because sometimes when we get heated, we just want to get everything out. There's a lot of emotion. And then there's really no problem. That was really no problem. And at the end of allowing each other to talk and to share, come to a consensus. It really ain't that major in the grand scheme of things.
Right, it really isn't. Yeah. So let's talk about good relationships. You know, some couples are like on a high, everything's going well, but then, you know, they may have something that it makes it turn. But in good relationships, how important is it for, I say, us care? Not just self-care.
That's a good time.
In the good times. What are your thoughts on that?
I think in a good time, you have to have like a schedule. Date night. Date night has to be essential. If that's Wednesday, you have to be sure that that date night is secured.
So it can't be random?
It can't be random.
Okay. Oh.
And if you come to my practice, you have to have vacations. You cannot go through life without vacation.
Would you tell somebody that for the people in the back? Say that for the people down to the back.
There is a word that does not exist. Staycations, what is a staycation? That doesn't work.
Just a made up foolishness.
Because made up foolishness, and you're stuck in the same environment, you're getting the same phone calls, you're on the same social media. You don't need that. You need some vacation.
Right. Even if it's simple, because a lot of people, when they think of vacation, oh my God, can I afford it? Can I do it? Even if it's somewhere, not here, obviously, 60 miles down the road, it's still considered a vacation.
You know, you changing the scenery.
Just changing the
scenery. Allowing yourself to breathe. Have fun. Go to a different restaurant. You can go to Savannah, Myrtle Beach. There are a lot of places you can go that are inexpensive. And a lot of times what you think is expensive is really not. But that becomes so important when you're talking about a healthy relationship, doing things together, doing things with each other.
That's what I mean, that's what I'm saying about the break. Because me and my husband like connected on a different level, because like we went out together. I was like, oh, you real cool. You know, that's how I felt.
But I'd like to know how to balance that, though, Dr. O, because, you know, you get into these relationships, well, I love me some ham, you know what I mean? But then there's real life. So how do you balance your relationship and real life?
I think what we all have clocks. Time we go to sleep, time we go to work, time we want to have fun. I think that it's very important if there are other things that you do, work, community service, you have to be sure that those things are part of you. Because if all you can think about is him or her, when they're not available, paranoia kicks in. Where are you? Where'd you go? So you have to have a life.
Come on, somebody.
You gotta have a life.
With that, don't you have to like set those, like when you said before, set those kind of boundaries? Like when you're at work, I don't feel like you should be calling 15 million times. Oh, what you have for lunch today? Can't you find out when you get home?
That's cute in the beginning, you know, but it gets old.
And it becomes controlling.
And you have to be careful that you don't make your partner feel like they're being controlled. Yeah. Because when you pull them in, they'll pull back.
Yes.
And then you've got a problem.
Yes.
Because they won't answer the
Speaking
text.
Speaking of that self-paranoia. Let's just stick to the paranoia for a minute. Sometimes we misconstrue the way that our significant other is communicating by distance, but they're being distant. They're not talking to me. So how do we manage ourselves? How do we govern ourselves to the point where we don't jump to conclusions in that moment of of them maybe taking that moment that you were talking about, that beat? Mm-hmm. Like, how do we, like, determine, oh, well, he taking a beat, let me do my thing, without thinking, oh, he's cheating on me, he doesn't want to talk to me. Right. How do you manage that paranoia?
You breathe and you don't respond. Mm. First, take a deep breath. Okay.
Max, breathe.
He's somewhere, she's somewhere. Then you just chill out. You don't go to Instagram. Mm. You don't go to Facebook. And you don't send a nasty text.
Mm-hmm.
Because what happens is, when they don't respond, we
tell them. That's a text.
You send these texts. And before you know it, everybody's mad.
Yeah.
So you want to take a deep breath and don't respond.
Yes.
Wait it out.
And as we round out this amazing conversation, you talk about having fun in relationships. I know you said, you know, set the date nights. What does that having fun in relationships mean?
When we think of fun, we think of laughing.
Mm-hmm.
If everything you do is intense, stressful, and there's no fun, you gotta have fun.
Yeah.
You gotta laugh at each other. You gotta have a quick joke every now and then. You gotta have fun.
Yeah.
So make each other laugh.
Yeah.
That's what keeps the relationship healthy.
It does. I can't stand a fun snatcher. Well, tell us about your live sessions on Facebook.
You're able to call. I'm on Facebook, Instagram. You're able to call Facebook every now and then if I'm there. Ask a couple of questions, not too deep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then we can help you, and we provide that information to everybody.
That's right.
Awesome.
Yes, because we all need it. So thank you so much for joining us. We love relationship advice. Be sure to follow Dr. Owens on Instagram to ask Dr. Owell. No, ask Dr. O.
There you go.
There you go.
There you go.
There's some comma